this year this week. Same as last week. Ephesians 2, 11 through 22. Therefore, remember that formerly you who are Gentiles by birth and called uncircumcised by those who call themselves the circumcision, that done in the body by the hands of men. Remember that at that time you were separated from Christ, excluded from citizenship in Israel, and foreigners to the covenants of the promise, without hope and without God in the world. But now, in Christ Jesus, you who once were far away have been brought near through the blood of Christ. For he himself is our peace, who has made the two one and has destroyed the barrier, the dividing wall of hostility, by abolishing in his flesh the law with its commandments and regulations. His purpose was to create in himself one new man out of the two, thus making peace, and in this one body to reconcile both of them to God through the cross, by which he put to death their hostility. He came and preached to you who were far away, and peace to those who were near. For through him we both have access to the Father by one Spirit. Consequently, you are no longer foreigners and aliens, but fellow citizens with God's people and members of God's household. From the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Christ Jesus himself as the chief cornerstone. In him the whole building is joined together and rises to become a holy temple in the Lord. And in him you too are being built together to become a dwelling in which God lives by his Spirit. Father, we thank you for this day and the opportunity to come together and worship God together with our brothers and sisters in Christ. We thank you for the word that you have prepared to pass the seed. Give him strength and wisdom and ability to deliver it as you do, and that we would take it and live it and show it to the world. In Jesus' name.
And so who are you? And God has come back. And he speaks to you. Wait a minute.
Thank you. that is the one thing you say, it's really a big thing. But when you travel, you recognize our sinfulness, you recognize our inability to save ourselves, and you seek to save us. You get to the message. You get to the message. And what is that? It's really fascinating to me. As I read this book, I'm looking into a deep word of it. He says to the crazy thing, he says, I believe, God, and I'm going to send some of that. And we're going to do greater things than I've ever done. Thank you. When God came in the form of man, he was lifted with him. He lifted himself to the form of a man. And so he could go to this group of people and do this, and he could go to this group of people and do this. And so all within a 5 to 10 mile radius, this entire life, he wouldn't do that. But he comes back as a living stone, and we accept him as the Lord and Savior. We become the living stone. So look at all what we can do. Jesus was born in 707. He never got on the king's job. He never got the king's ship. We are all those things. And it says, God is adding to this story. Now, let's think about a little bit of the story of saying this. you play that music, but I'm going to play that. And the word is, the word means, the word means that you can do a little less. They don't recognize it as a thing that's extraordinary. What happens is, if you have not continuously put the terms of Jesus Christ, these directly also, instead of being on a firm foundation, we are carefully on a foundation. What happens to someone with addiction if they only throw it away and make a commitment to stop them for them to do? What happens to a building if it's not firmly on the foundation? Well, we're going to start to see work, right? Any knowledge that we see work, right? We start to see work, we start to see work, we start to see work. What eventually happens to your house? So what it means is, you're built upon the Word of God. You're built upon the Word of God. You're built upon the Word of God, and we can't pick and choose. People do this all the time. We pick and choose. Okay, I will not judgment my neighbor's house or wife or the kids. What are we doing now? The other part. We're not faithful to our family. We're not faithful to our sexuality. We're not faithful to keeping ourselves holy. And so we are firmly our foundation. Next, we only have a little contact sitting on, and eventually, it might be. When you are no longer partners or friends, the citizens of God's people and the people of God's house, is on the foundation of apostles and prophets and the Word of God, is self-confessed as the two points that in Him the whole building is joined together, and rises to be carried by faith. And it is thank you.